Yo, what is up, everybody? Welcome to another Madden 13 online game. Today we got the Carolina Panthers and the Arizona Cardinals. And what I have is a different playbook. I'm not running my usual Steelers playbook on offense, but I'll get to that when I come on offense, because right now he's on offense and he's going for a big 4th-and-2 to start the game, and he ends up running up the gut with Cam Newton. I made a nice tackle in 3rd-and-6, but he ends up getting the first down. He had a legitimate wildcat, heavy Panther scheme and all this, so I had to watch out for that. Here, this is not even part of the wildcat. This is just going deep. Somehow, Patrick Peterson gets burned. I contribute to that by trying to go for the ball hawk. I was jamming Y for the life of me, and it didn't work. I still don't know why that thing only works sometimes. But Patrick Peterson is here to redeem himself. He's trying to take this one back to the house, but number 81 is trying to keep up. Can he stay up? Unfortunately, he does impact the play, and Patrick Peterson can't go all the way to the house. But it's okay, because maybe Stephens Howling can go all the way. Maybe not, but that's a damn good run to start off the game. Got like, what, 30 yards in that one play there. Second down and 12, hitting up Roberts here. You know, just moving the ball. You know, just trying to get a feel for the offense, because this isn't my usual playbook. Unfortunately, 3rd-and-inches, we don't get that. So we go for the fullback dive and 4th down. I have no idea how I got that one, but I'll take it, because it looks short every bit of the way. Second down and 9, I think he's supposed to be using the running back, and we had him going out the backfield, so we got an easy 1 yard line there. We didn't get the touchdown. We got stopped at the 1. That's about to cost us here, because on 2nd down and goal, we get shoved all the way back to the 5. So we lost 4 yards there. 3rd down and 5. Thankfully, we get this one. We don't have to settle for the field goal, because he actually run command to the right and actually got me there. So it's okay, though. We tied the game back up. We got a touchdown, and now he's back. I got to prepare back for the Wildcat. It took me a little bit to get adjusted to this thing. You see I'm giving up some plays here. Not this one. This one didn't go good from the start. He ended up losing 3 yards, and Nick Campbell makes the tackle. But on 3rd down and 10, he gets a nice inside positioning throw to the tight end. Toller was there. He looked like he was there, but like, I don't know, this is the defenders. I have no idea what they're doing in this game. They're 2nd down and 9. That was my coverage. I was trying to cheat my coverage. He ends up getting the curl, and he goes all the way for the touchdown. So, pretty shoddy tackling there by myself, too. For some reason, oh, here's the flea flicker. Here's why I changed my playbook, so I could throw it into double coverage and throw a pick. Oh, my God. I actually don't have the San Francisco playbook. I know I ran that one to start off the year, the San Francisco one, but this is actually the Chargers playbook, because the Chargers have the flea flicker too. So I figured, let me run with San Diego here. They might have some good plays, I don't know. So so far no good though. We got a touchdown, but we also threw a really bad pick. I don't know, I can't say it was bad though, the playbook. But here, 3rd down and 6, we make a nice stop, and he ends up going for it on 4th down and 6, up 14-0, tries to, like, you know, go for it all. Could have just taken his 3 points. Instead, he ends up tripping up on his own offensive line. It would have been close if I made it there with Wilson. He probably would have gotten the first down, but instead, you know, he ends up getting screwed over, I guess. I don't know. I'll take that one, damn it. It's okay. 7:14, 2-minute warning. I want to get a quick touchdown here. Unfortunately, we're not going to get a touchdown ever if Kevin Cobb's going to throw it like that. And that was kind of the story of this game. Kevin Cobb wasn't accurate. Todd Heap was dropping the ball like crazy. Other people were dropping the ball like Foyd and stuff. And I had to overcome that. You know, Larry Fitzgerald was my one reliable receiver, but I couldn't even get him involved in the game that much because I didn't know the play. So I was trying to run that play for him. I don't know what the hell happened there. That's just lack of timing, since I don't know the playbook. But 3rd down and 10, you know, just going to the bread and butter, throwing an inside streak to the tight end, get a 1st down. Next play, running hurry up, throw a curl to the tight end on the outside, let him get position, and a touchdown. So that's good. 14-14 at the half. I'm satisfied where we're at right now. I mean, I just got to play better defense and, like, help protect the fact that I'm not playing good offense. 6 seconds left. Let's see if we can get a pick here quick with Patrick Peterson. No, we don't. We drop it. And everybody had drop hands, like stone hand syndrome for some reason in this game. Offense, defense, everybody. But that's the end of the half. Today's halftime show. For my PS3 subs, I got Madden 13, and I'm going to be playing that tonight. So if you see this, then look for me. My game tag is John Precise, the same one as my Xbox One. And if you need me to say it, I'm not going to say it, because that's going to be at the end of this video, okay? And the end of most of my videos. But tonight I'll be on, you know, just look for me. And, you know, hopefully I get a game with people. I'm probably going to get on somewhere between 10 o'clock and 1 o'clock a.m. Eastern. So, well, like 10 o'clock p.m. to 1 o'clock a.m. Eastern. And I'll try to stay up as late as I can to play as much people as possible. And I'll probably be playing Saturday too, Saturday night and stuff like that. So I'm not going to be recording any games though, since the PS3 is not at my place, it's at my mom's place. So you know, I don't feel like ringing in and stuff. But I'll probably record some in the future, though. We'll see how that works out. But I got the game, so we'll try that out. I think I ran a flea flicker to start the second half that didn't work. But, you know, I'm just trying to run random plays. I'm really legitimately running random plays. I'd never ran this playbook before. I didn't go into practice mode or anything like that because I don't lab. I'm not smart enough to lab. Like, it's a really simple concept, but I don't even go to practice mode. I just go straight into ranked games and see how it works. I really don't care. You know, at this point, I don't care about my record that much, to be honest. Here we got a nice first down because of roughing the passer. He tried to go for the big hit. Kind of, like, baited him into that one, to be honest. Their A is open, but I see Malcolm Floyd. I'm like, let me just try him. I don't feel like throwing to the tight end. He might get picked off. Floyd ends up dropping it, though. Third down and five. The safety makes a great play on the ball. Nothing I can do about that. This is a great safety play, and I take my points instead of getting a touchdown there to Fitz because we had the cornerback tripped up, but the safety covered his ass there pretty much. But we got the lead. That's good. We burn up quite a bit of clock, and that's what I want to do. I don't want to give him too much time to run on this Wildcat. There, this dude is rated like a 95 somehow, Adrian Wilson. I thought a little bit overrated, but still, I mean, you're going to be rated a 95. You can't drop that. But thankfully, third down and seven, that tough Cardinals defense. Calais Campbell getting the sack, and the offense isn't worth shit because Todd Heap can't catch a ball for the life of him. Malcolm Floyd, he's not going to catch this one either. Third down and 11, we got another drop, and there's that drive. Two potential first downs dropped and end up punting the ball. And that's what I don't need because I'm trying to, like, fixate here with a playbook that I barely know about. And I got guys dropping the ball on offense, making, like, matters worse here. And now Cam Newton decides to go into beast mode here pretty much. And he's gaining a ton of yards now. Almost gets the first down there. Second down and one, he just goes and shoves it in there. Patrick Peterson had no chance to bring down Cam Newton in the backfield. And in here, though, he tries to go for D'Angelo Williams. He had the tight end wide open. He tried to hit up D'Angelo Williams, but thankfully Patrick Peterson comes up with this one. And you think there's nowhere to go. I only see one way, and that's the end zone, and that's where we're heading. Somehow, I made through all those Cardinals, and I got the touchdown, and it's 24-14 now. I just had to see the score real quick there. I can do simple math, unfortunately. But, 24-14, that's big because my offense has not been worth the shit this game. Between the drops and everything else, you know, I've been struggling. And Gay drops the ball there, coming from the Steelers. He was the scapegoat of the Steelers, but he's going to make the play this time. He doesn't drop it, and we get the pick now. I know what you're thinking. This game's probably over. Let me hop off and see who else put up a Madden video today. This game's not over, okay, because I got a crappy offensive line here. To start off with, Charles Johnson just beats that dude one-on-one. Had the X wide open, but I couldn't get the ball off. And he gets the ball back, so now he has a chance to go and you know, score real quick. That's, if he can score for a 2-minute warning, that's golden for him. Or, you know, he could just depend on onside kicks since they're so easy to get in this game, since, you know, everybody lacks awareness. And you could get touchdowns when you get wide open plays like that. I'll just blame that one on William Gay, too. Why not? I don't know. Here, Darren Washington, I'm telling you, everybody had drop hands, like stone hand syndrome in this game. I don't know why. Third down and 10, this is a huge third down, and he runs out the pocket, but we stop him. Fourth down and 2. What's he going to do? He's trying to throw. He's looking for somebody. And he's got nobody. Darryl Washington makes the play there. 2:15 left in the game. We just get a first down here with Stephens Howlings. And I know what you're thinking. Let me hop off now. He's not going to convince me to watch this any longer. Don't leave yet because it's not over. It is not over. Third down and 6. He calls his second timeout. Now, for some reason, I decide to be a bold ass and go for the flea flicker. He covers the curl route, which I've tried to get. And nothing's open, so I just end up taking a sack. Hope Cobb doesn't fumble it. Just make him use his last timeout. And yeah, you know, he's got to score 10 points in a minute. Oh, God. Oh, God. That's not the way you want to start. First play, bombs it to D'Angelo Williams and gets the touchdown. I don't know what the hell happened to me. Then he goes for the onside kick. I don't know what this guy is doing. I don't know what he's doing. We're just going to... I don't know, man. Let's just go back into the commentary here. Because he just hopped right into field goal range. So right now we have a chance to go into overtime. But he could easily score a touchdown. He's got me on my back heels here. I could give up a touchdown here. He's running with Cam. Time's running out. But he's got... You know, he's moving everywhere. William Gate is catching the freaking ball. No one told you to swat it. Like, Jesus Christ, dude, had a wide open pick. 12 seconds left. We force him to throw it out of bounds. And he kicks the field goal there for some reason instead of going for third down. I guess he didn't want to chance having the clock run out on him. Which is smart, you know what I mean? So 6 seconds left. I decided I'm going to go for the flea flicker here. Like an idiot. Throw it to Fitz. And I get picked. And he could get a field goal here and just end the game because I decided to be a dumbass. Thankfully, He misses the field goal. And we got a chance to take this one back. Patrick Peterson's got 98 speed. I got faith in you, buddy. Let's do it. Let's do it. Ah, oh, Jonathan Stewart trips us up, though. I think that, yeah, it's Jonathan Stewart tripped us up. And I was trying to process. It was a split decision whether to go to the left or to the right. I saw he was kind of swerving up on the right side. So I was like, you know what? Let me hit up there. Thought I had open field, but I didn't account for Jonathan Stewart coming out of nowhere. I didn't even account for him to be on special teams, for crying out loud. Like, when the hell did that dude play special teams? But, we're going to overtime, and we got the ball. Oh, please get this, guys. Please get this. I miss it, but thankfully, this Leech guy picks it up. So, now it's overtime. Let's see what we can do. Fitz is wide open down the field, and I eventually realize it. But Cobb throws it out of bounds. Now, I'm going back to the same play. See if it gets wide open again. It gets wide open again. But Cobb's thrown it to the sidelines again, and we get picked up. Oh, Kevin Cobb, please throw me a good ball. Because I was pass precisioning up. And he makes the pick. I'm sick right now because he's in field goal range. But we got a negative 2 yard loss. Maybe we could force something here. Second down and 12. He tries to take a shot deep. He is so lucky that went out of bounds because Patrick Peterson had a great shot to pick that off. Now third down and 12. We jumped the route. And we get nothing. We jumped the route. We should have had a pick there. It was a 50-50 ball, but usually the defender gets the pick in Madden 13. And then he goes for it on fourth down. I have no idea why he didn't kick his field goal, but he goes for it. And my linebacker decides he's going to blow a coverage here. And then he runs it in for a touchdown to top it all off. And, yeah. If I didn't break my controller earlier, I probably would have broken in this game. But I hope you guys like this game. Subscribe if you haven't. And I'll catch you guys next time. Not with the Chargers playbook, though. As much as I love running the flea flicker, as you saw in that game, it was as ineffective as possible as it could have possibly been. So we're hopping off the flea flicker for now until I find out what the hell to do with that. I might actually have to hit practice mode. I don't know. But, yeah, I'll catch you guys next time for more Madden 13 Online. Peace out, guys.